Hello everyone, welcome to today's tutorial. Today we would learn how to make this beautiful lotus painting. The reason I chose this topic is because it's a very vibrant subject. Also, this is a flower that is highly regarded in various cultures. So I thought this could be an interesting subject for us. I start by sketching out a flower, a bud and two leaves. I'm making my lines a little dark so that you can see them clearly. However, I would suggest you to use an H pencil and draw the lines very faintly because that is easier for us to cover with paint. Once we are done with the sketch, we start with the background coloring. And what I've done here is I have tried to keep the edges a little dark, and I've used the lighter tones, especially near the flower or in the center. I've darkened the corners using a bit of black mixed with viridian green, and to bring in brightness, lemon yellow was used. While working on the petals, the points that we need to keep in mind are that the lines should be fine. To achieve that, we should use a long hair brush or our tiniest detailing brush. Immediately after pulling the lines, we should slightly smudge them with a wet brush, and this would ensure that the lines would look softer and would blend slightly to the base coat. This process has to be repeated with various shades several times to give the petals a beautiful fullness. Now I have tried to keep the base and the tips of the petals darker while maintaining a brightness in the middle. I move back and forth between the petals to give the paint some time to dry, and then I go back and fill in with more details. Now, this entire process would take some time, but then if we are patient and continue with it, at the end we would be left with beautiful petals. My suggestion to you before you attempt this work would be to watch the full video. It would help you to understand my approach better. Either you could use the same techniques or something that you are comfortable with. Please feel free to use any color which you feel might benefit your work. Art is all about having fun. It's all about your expressions after all. Once the petals are dry, I give them a border. If it's a green petal, it takes a pale green border, and if it's a pink petal, then it takes a very light pink border. Keeping the center of each petal bright would ensure that the petals have a fuller look. To do that, I have used white on my pink petals and I've used a lot of lemon yellow on my green petals. As was mentioned earlier, you would see me move back and forth between the petals. Maybe you would see me putting the base coat on one petal and adding details on the other and again coming back to the previous petal. The reason I'm doing this is to save some time, and also I want to give each layer enough time to dry before I move on and add more details. Viridian green was applied to the base of the leaf. However, you would see that the color doesn't remain same throughout the base. It's darker in certain areas. To achieve that darkness, a little bit of black was added to the viridian green. To show the curves and the bends, a lighter color combination was made. So I mixed viridian green with white. With that, I pulled few thick lines along the edges and tried to blend that lightly with the base coat using a slightly damp brush. Also added a little bit of sap green to the sides of it so that while blending it would blend smoothly with the base coat. The other side of the leaf didn't take any light highlights, the reason being it was behind the flower and it wouldn't be receiving too much light, hence wanted to keep it dark. My approach on the second leaf was pretty much the same. The color used on the stem was viridian green. It is however dark on one side and light on the other. To do so, a little bit of black was added to the viridian green to make it darker, and for the lighter side a little bit of white was added. It was blended well in the middle. Once the base coat of the leaf has dried, we add more details to it. We make a combination of light sap green, which is sap green plus yellow. With that, we make fine veins and give it a border too. We also use pale turquoise color to add more highlights inside the leaf. Now you would see these lines and highlights are thick in some places and very fine and thin in certain places. We need to play with the length and the width because it makes the painting look more interesting, more realistic, rather than keeping them all of the same size. I have approached the bud in the same manner in which I have painted my flower. And my suggestion would be to keep focusing on the strokes, as we need to get real fine strokes to make it look beautiful. And you might have to do several rounds and keep going back and forth for the layers to dry and add details. But then do not skip these steps, as that is very important and it makes our painting look beautiful. Finally, I added few dewdrops to my leaves. I made the shape with light viridian green, and the shadows were made with dark viridian green, which is viridian green plus black, and the highlights were given with white. At the end, I felt that some of my petals could have been shaped better and decided to do it anyways. I felt it would be better not to edit it out and show you my corrections as it is, as one can learn a lot from mistakes too. I've been asked before that is it possible to make corrections in acrylics at a later stage? And my answer is yes, it is possible. Acrylics is a very forgiving medium and it gives us a lot of opportunities for corrections. And it is very difficult to reactivate the paint after it dries. Hence, corrections at a later stage is easily possible. Hope this video was fun and informative for you. Do let me know your thoughts in the comment section. Thank you. If you like my content, please do like, share and subscribe.